First, let's answer the big question. What is replication and why do we care about it? Replication ensures that data and actions are synchronized between the server and all the clients in your multiplayer game. Without replication, your server might think one thing and the client might see something completely different. Not good. Let's make it visual. Imagine I'm a client and I shoot. Without replication, the server doesn't know about my shot.
Hacker. Hacker.
And no one else in the game sees it. Now that's awkward. With replication, everyone sees it. The same bang. This is the heart of multiplayer development. If you're planning a multiplayer game, start by understanding replication. Don't do what I did and start a single player game only to try converting it later. Trust me, that's a pain. You don't want that. Let's talk about variables. Variables are the foundation of any game. Things like player health, ammo count, or scores. But here's the thing, you have to tell Unreal which variables should replicate. Here's how. Open your variable in Blueprint Editor, right click the variable and select Replicate it under the Replication dropdown. Save your blueprint. Now what does this do? It ensures that when the server updates this variable, all clients see the same value. For example, if player's health changes, all players will see the updated health. Common pitfall? Don't assume all variables need replication. Only replicate what's necessary, otherwise you'll bog down the network. Variables are just data. What about actions like firing a weapon or opening a door? That's where functions come in, and yes, they can be replicated too. There are three types of replicated functions. Server functions, these run on the server. Use these for actions like dealing damage or spawning objects. Client functions. These run on the client. Use them for client-specific effects like screen shake. Multicast functions. These run on both the server and the clients. Use these for global events like explosions. Imagine you're changing the color of an object in the level. To ensure everyone sees the color change, you'll use multicast functions. Create the function, mark it as multicast, and call it from the server. Don't forget about that. Good news, Unreal has built-in replication for character movement. Walking, running, and jumping work right out of the box. But if you want to add something fancy like sprinting or leaping, you'll need to get your hands dirty. Here's how. Use a server function to handle the logic on the server. Add client-side prediction so the action feels smooth even if there's lag. Test for edge cases like what happens if a player tries to leap while lagging. Unreal 5 is improving replication all the time, and there are plugins available to help with the advanced movement. Objects can also be replicated, but here's the catch. Physics objects like rolling balls or thrown items don't replicate well on their own. Why? Physics isn't deterministic, meaning it can behave differently on each client. To fix this, you can set up a custom replication framework. Or you can use plugins like MoveSync, which you can get at the Fab Store. I heard great things about it. Without these fixes, one player might see a ball rolling left while the other sees it rolling right. Not a deal. When working with replication, always test in different play modes to catch potential issues early. Standalone runs a single player instance without networking. Play as a listen server, one player acts as both the client and the server. Dedicated server mode, best for testing how clients connect to central server. Multiple clients allows you to check interactions between multiple players. Testing with different play modes will help you debug synchronization issues before they become a problem. Now let's learn how to handle late joiners. What happens when a new player joins a game that's already in progress? If you don't handle replication properly, they'll miss important states like an open door or a destroyed crate. To fix this, use unrep functions to update new players on the current state of replicated objects. Initialize objects and begin play to ensure they're ready for late joiners. I actually made a full video on handling late joiners. You can check it out by clicking on the info box in the upper right hand corner, or I'll also link it at the end of this video. By the way, if you're enjoying this, hit the like button and subscribe so you don't miss any of my latest Unreal Engine tutorials. Now let's talk about net update frequency. Net update frequency controls how often an object state updates over the network. Here's how to think about it. High frequency for fast moving objects like vehicles. Now low frequency for static objects like props. Adjusting this can save bandwidth without sacrificing gameplay quality. Now let's talk about net call distance square. This determines the distance at which the server stops replicating an object to a client. An example will be like a battle royale game. You don't need to replicate a destroyed crate to players who are miles away. By setting a call distance, you optimize the game and save resources. So there we have it. We cover replicating variables, replicating functions, replicating characters, replicating objects, testing play modes, handling late joiners, and net update frequency, and last, net call distance square. Multiplayer can feel overwhelming, but trust me, once you get replication down, the rest starts to click. Got questions? Drop them in the comments and I'll tackle them in the next video. Don't forget to like and subscribe and keep creating. See you next time, dev heads.